Anopheles mosquito versus kill sign. I leave to you the literature which is available in any MCQ book. The larvae with a siphon tube is more a feature of Aedes, Manzonia and kill sign, not Anopheles. Single X, boat shaped X, parallelly resting to the water surface without siphon tube, they are all the features of Anopheles, is what you have to ultimately remember. When did ESI came into vogue, doctor? 1948. Then cannabis is very commonly abused and addicted in the case of the Indian scenario. If you want to evaluate vaccination coverage in an area, it is the cluster sampling which will be the best method. Tell me, doctor, what is the karyotype of a complete mole? Means? You mean 46 double X, not 69 XXY or anything? 46XX, only Dr. Siri said haploid, most of the people agree 46XX is what need to be remembered. So what is that medical education committee which said send house surgeons for 3 months to SPM posting so that at least in medical college they could not fall in love, they can go to the PhD posting and try to fall in love and ultimately discover there is no time for love or anything or romance, there is only NEET exam impending. Okay, which committee said paid holiday shall be given to every house surgeon for 3 months? Very good, it is the Bohr committee which has proposed. Then all these committees you have to read, doctor. Screening in children is very cost effective for TB, vision impairment, vitamin A deficiency, not for BP, not for hypertension. Comes now solid questions of SPM. Giving you easy questions is a boring job. Now tell me, doctor, how do you calculate the relative risk in this given scenario? First thing, you have to put a 2x2 table. Coronary event, no coronary event, with and without ACE inhibitor. Then you get the values A, B, C, D. Then you must know the formula. Relative risk is A by A plus C by B by B plus D. That makes it 120 by 400 by 100 by 300. Becomes the answer. So if you know how to put it and if you know what is the formula for the relative risk, then how do you calculate odds ratio? AD by BC is what you have to fundamentally calculate. Mean values of the triglycerides between two populations are compared. Whenever you compare mean values, we take into consideration two sample t-test is the one which is taken into consideration, is what need to be remembered. Now, doctor, a study is conducted. 30 patients out of 70 who did not take abiraterone had arrhythmia. What is the odds ratio? AD by BC, you have to calculate. For that, you must know how to put the 2x2 table. अगर 2x2 टेबल लगा दिए तो फॉर्मूला अप्लाई कर दिए तो यू कैन कैलकुलेट एनीथिंग बेसिकली. नाउ दिस इज ए गुड क्वेश्चन, व्हाट इज मीन बाय पावर ऑफ ए स्टैटिस्टिकल स्टडी? यस्टरडे वी डिस्कस नो अल्फा एरर, बीटा एरर, लास्ट संडे 1 - β विल गिव यू द पावर. सो फर्स्ट यू मस्ट नो हाउ टू कैलकुलेट द बीटा. So, type 1 error describes the probability of seeing a difference when there is no difference in reality. For example, online exam versus paper based exam. We are thinking that there is a difference. So in reality there is no difference, because questions are same, no images, no assertion reasons, no case based questions, same single liners. Instead of putting answers on paper, we put on screen. So but we are able to see a difference, that is called type 1 error. Then type 2 error, saying that there is no difference between, though there is difference, then you call it as type 2 beta error. 1 minus beta will give you the power. So in this given case, doctor, what is the beta value? There is a 20% probability of concluding that there is no difference, though there is difference. Hence 0.2 is the beta. 1 minus 0.2 is 0.8 is the power of the study. That is what you will basically conclude. Okay, doc. Now, a patient's BP was recorded in ICCU. Maximum recorded value was 124, minimum was 114. But suddenly you discovered 164. When such a sudden big value comes, which of these values won't be affected? Out of 240 marks, everyone was getting 190, 184, 190, 194, doctor. Suddenly one fellow with a mutation in the brain, took the exam and his score is 239. So because of that, what happened? Everybody's median value, standard deviation value, variance value, everything get altered because of that one fellow. Otherwise we are all equally good and equally bad. So mode is not affected. So what is that extremely big or extremely small value called as? It's called as outlier. So in a given data set, a outlier can affect median, standard deviation, variance, but not mode. Why? How do you calculate mode? We will arrange everybody's score in descending order and take the central guy. So the first ranker may get 210 marks out of 240 or 239 out of 240, doesn't matter. He still stands number one and he stands there. And once we organize everybody in descending order and catch the middle fellow, we will be definitely there. So mode is not affected with the outliers, whereas mean value, everything get affected. Okay, doc. Now, a new test is used for diagnosis of UTI. Sensitivity 70%, specificity 90%. We have done a study on 100 patients who really have UTI and 200 who really do not have. Then how many false positive are there in this study? Once more, the idea is to basically put a 2-into-2 table. Disease positive, disease negative. True positive, true negative. Then, test positive, test negative. We have to basically place them. Now, doctor, how do you calculate specificity? Specificity is true negatives, that is D, divided by false positives plus true negatives. That is all negative for disease will come in denominator. So 0.9, which is the specificity, why it has been given, no? 90% is the specificity of the test. So 0.9 is equal to D. What is D? True negative. True negative by B plus D. B plus D is what? all the people who don't have disease, which is 200, which is already given in the problem. So 0.9 is equal to D by 200. So D is equal to 200 into 0.9, which will give you 180. But what is D? D is two negatives. Then how do you calculate false positives? Already you know. False positives plus true negatives together is equivalent to 200. Already you got true negatives is how many? 180. So what is left over is B, false positives. How many are there? 200 minus 180, which will give you 20. So false positives are basically 20. So to calculate false positives, which value do you require, doctor? All the people who are disease negative, specificity, you have to know. Using that, you calculate true negatives. Once you calculate true negatives, you subtract that from all the people who are disease negative, and then that's how you get the false positives. Examiner asks you what false positives only, no? Whereas if you want to know true positives, what you need to depend on? Not specificity, you need to depend on sensitivity. So that is a very important thing. I leave to you in the literature, even how to calculate the value of the C. What is C? False negatives. False negatives, to calculate them you need sensitivity. False positives ko calculate karne ke liye, what is required? Specificity. You didn't get? If you apply formulas and little mathematics, you will get it. No big deal. Now, what is reliability, validity, accuracy, sensitivity? Is an important question. A reliable test is reproducible. It gives similar or very close results on repeated measurement. That is a reliability. Validity means what it is expected to measure, could it be able to do that or not, is called validity. Sensitivity means it's the ability to identify the presence of the disease at all. And specificity is the ability to identify the absence of the disease, is specificity. Hence, specificity is reflected by true negatives, sensitivity is detected by, depends on true positives, is what need to be remembered.